This video is a preview of the new text-based cathedral floor plans that I've created. These are some of the originals that did not have text. This time I actually bound some of them in an artist book, and I'm going to give a little tutorial about binding an artist book for you. These are the first text-based cathedral books that I first started in 2007 and have just finished up recently. They include scriptural passages. I'm going to start with a list of materials that you need for the project. You will need a decorative or plain end paper to go inside the book, some kind of paper or fabric to go over the cover, some book cloth, which will be for the spine. You will also need Davy board or some kind of hard, stiff cardboard for the cover, linen thread, some regular sewing needles, maybe an awl if you can find one of those. A bone folder will be very helpful. You should use a pH neutral glue like a PVA adhesive and a stiff bristle brush to apply that glue. Whenever you're making a book, you should probably start with a dummy book to work out the order of pages, particularly if you're printing on two different sides of the paper. So here you can see that I've created some of the signatures, as they are called, which is each of these sections that get sewn into the book. And here they have not been folded yet, but I constantly go back over and over again to make sure before I start the folding and even the sewing later to make sure that I have the pages in the right order, because it is too much of a problem to take things back apart and refold it and re-sew it. You'll see that the bone folder doesn't really put a really hard crease on the pages. You just need it to fold it enough so that it's kind of rounded on the end, but that everything is even on each of your signatures. Aside from the dummy book, I also made a test sample book that has blank pages in it that I'll use as a sketchbook just to remind me of the process before I started. It's good to not do it on something as precious as something that has artwork in it already. And after folding all of the signatures, I'm now going to mark where the holes are going to go through for the sewing. I made a little template that I put across the top, and then I can just take a ruler here and mark down the back sides, which are eventually going to be covered anyway, but that'll help me know where I need to put the holes in for sewing. You can do this in different configurations. There are a lot of different ways to bind books. Mine allows for holes through a row on the top and the bottom, and then there are two rows of two below that. That will create three long stitches inside the center of the signatures. So here I'm just using a regular sewing needle. The awl that I talked about before is a little thicker, and it's just easier to handle and get it in the right place. But if you don't go out and buy one of those, it's okay. You can use just these regular needles. You have to be careful as it comes through in the center. You want to keep looking into the center, because sometimes it'll go off of the crease, or you might miss, depending on how many pages are in your signature, you might miss the interior one and go into the wrong spot and then not have all the holes that you need. Here I'm just measuring the thread. Measure from the top hole to the bottom hole of one of the signatures. Multiply that by the number of signatures that you have, and then add about 6 or 7 inches onto that. You can't really put a knot into your thread because it's hard to go through the holes. So what I end up doing is piercing kind of the little tail of the thread. I do it twice. So you're basically, after you stick it in there, you're pointing it back through the thread, and it actually does keep it on the needle without having too much of a problem of it coming back off as you're sewing. I just checked one more time to make sure everything was in the right order. I start from the back, up at the top, I leave a little tail behind, then come back through with one stitch. At this point, you don't have to be really tight with your stitching, but you do need to look back and forth between the front and the back to make sure that you are, again, getting through the holes and not coming through some side area. It's kind of difficult to put the needle back through a hole that you've already come through, so just take your time on doing this, and that's easier. So you can see that I'm making sure I get through each hole of each page in the signature there. So you go through that first section, and then you start sewing back into the next section. So you just kind of do a straight sewing come back in. Where the change happens right here is that you can see where the two holes close together are. You're going to take your needle and go back into the previous signature through the little stitch that is right there. It actually makes like a little bit of an X, and then you go back through the second hole of that little section. And then do another large stitch inside, and then do the same thing to the next set of double holes there. You're going to go back through that little stitch and make another little X, come back through that, and then you have the two essentially sewn together, but they aren't sewn very tightly yet. They don't have to be tight until you've gotten through everything, and it makes it a little more difficult if you keep tightening it up that way. To make sure that I do keep it tight at this point, I will take a little clamp and put it on each end to make sure that they're both together. You don't want to pull toward yourself. You want to pull down the whole length of the book whenever you're pulling. Here I was taking the needle and pulling through those little X stitches just to pull up any slack, and then I've got it all pulled down so it's as tight as I can get it, and I'm going to make a knot on the top where I first started with that little tail that I left open, and the rest of the thread that I'm still sewing with. From there I can take those clamps off and then go back into the next section. Do the same thing again with the last signature here. Again, you're gonna go through and make another one of these little X stitches. Make it go through the stitch that is in the middle signature. Instead of the end one. That way it pulls everything across equally and keeps it pretty even there. You can do this with more signatures than what is here. This is just what I needed for this particular book. So again, I'm going to clamp it to make it as tight as it can be, and then I'm going to tie off again on the end once I'm done with that. Making sure that those little X stitches are as tight as I can make them there, all the way across, pull down. And then you're going to go into that center signature with your needle. You're going to come around there and knot that off, and then trim off those little tails off the end. And the first part is all set. And while it looks basically like a book now, the steps for making the cover are what take kind of the longest time. So here is one of the end papers. It is cut to the size of what the signatures are, and here I'm just folding it over with the bone folder, and I'll do two of those. You have to make sure at this point you're gonna glue just the edge of it onto what is sewn already, and if there is a specific pattern, make sure that you're putting it on so that it matches. Otherwise, you may have things kind of upside down. I wipe off some of the glue on a piece of paper. And I am actually just doing a little line of you don't want it really sloppy kind of glue. And then you're going to put that right on the edge. Make sure it comes up to the spine and doesn't round in too far, or it pulls a little bit when you're doing your actual cover and when you're trying to open it later on. So you don't need that much glue on here, and you don't want it oozing out, so that's why I wipe it off there. And I always use a little piece of waste paper that I can go over the edge with that. Okay, use the bone folder again, get that glued down. Now we're going to actually work with the cover. You'll see that again I am clamping it down to get to the right size of that. I'm taking a very thin piece of paper. This is actually kind of an Asian paper. I believe it is masa is the kind that I had already cut to the right size of the spine. Again, using the PVA just to coat that kind of lightly all over the edge, the one side of that. And then I'm going to put it down across the back. You notice I did not glue the edge of the actual cover down to the book. I'm letting this be the first part that actually glues it together. So I'm taking the bone folder here, and because that is a thin piece of paper and it's very wet with the glue, it's very malleable, I can use the bone folder to push that into each of the little crevices in there. And that's really going to keep your book together. It's going to keep any of the little knots or tails off of coming inside of the book. And then you're just going to let that set. Now right here, I am taking some glue, and because I'm using cloth, I want to keep a nice even edge on the outside of the book. You'll see why this is going to be important on the cover. And so all I'm doing right now is putting a little bit of glue that is not seeping through. I'm checking to make sure that it doesn't come through on the other side. This is just going to keep the cloth from fraying when I cut it. I'm actually using the selvedge edge of the cloth because it's going to be the easiest for me to cut a straight line on it. And so I do this all down the edge of that. You can see that it still looks fine right there. And then I'm going to let that dry. So I have multiple books here. I let all of them dry with that backing on there. This little piece that I'm cutting is actually out of poster board. It's not, you know, it's a thicker paper that I'm using on that. And this is actually for the spine itself. So again, it fits the same size. It's probably a little smaller than what I had for the other piece that went down the back of the spine. Right now, I'm marking the center of that on the ends. You'll see why this is important. This is the book cloth. It's kind of papery on one side and is woven. It's probably linen, I think, on the other side. And I'm cutting the sections out of that. I leave about enough for it to go across the back, the spine, and about an inch on either side. So I marked the center ends of that on the inside, on the paper side of that, and I'm cutting like a little arrow, a triangle out on that. The reason is that will give me the very center, and I keep this little spine part centered. So there's the, and you can see how it lines up with the line that was on the piece of poster board. So again, like I did before, I'm putting glue over one side of this, and then I'm going to apply that down, all centered up on the piece of book cloth that I have there. So the lines that I have on there align completely with my lines that I had on the book cloth and with the little arrows. So after that's on there, then I put a little on the ends because I'm not going to have an open end. I'm going to actually fold this over. So on both of these ends, I fold that over and use the bone folder to make that nice and flat. I'm going to let this dry from here after I do both of these sides. So once it's completely dry, what I was showing is that I'm going to use the bone folder to actually crease on either side of that, because that will be what goes against the covers on each side. So this one, you do want it to be a very sharp crease on there, so you can use your bone folder to really push down more than you did when you were doing the signatures. I somehow missed the part where I glued that piece with the book cloth onto the back, but it just, again, see how I'm putting just a little bit of a line of glue on the piece of cloth here? You can see it's already glued on there. I just glued that on each side of the book, not all the way to the end, but made it really tight across there, and then that dried. Now I'm putting on the piece of fabric just on one side here. I made a little template that went in about 3/8 of an inch, and I'm taping that down again, and then glued this on here. That's that straight edge that I had originally glued, and then I ended up cutting it so that it would be really straight. But that's the only place that I glued it down to begin with. After that's dry, I come back in, and I'm going to do the top and the bottom on each side. You can see the rest of the book is all clamped up and is out of the way. I'm going to pull this with that little line of glue across, kind of up or down depending on how the book is, and also a little bit toward myself. I use the bone folder to really pull this tight across there, and then I'm going to do it on the other side as well. You are not gluing over the whole front surface of each of the covers. You're just going to do this little bit on the edge. Be careful and use kind of a dryish amount of glue there so that it doesn't ooze out. It can, if it gets on top of your fabric, it can discolor it, or if it's paper too. Some of this is going to be inside the end paper, but you just have to be careful about how you do that. So I only do those two sides right now. It's like one step at a time with this, and then I flip it over, clamp that out of the way, and do the same thing again. A very thin line of somewhat dryish glue going down the edge there, and then on the other side, and pulling it both across and toward myself, and using the bone folder to really get that. It's just the tension of gluing from one side to the other is what keeps it straight on the front without having any wrinkles. You'll notice that if you're using fabric, you're going to pull little bits and pieces that are going to fray off there, and so this is the time when you can pull those off and trim them down. You don't want too much of that showing up because it may show up through the end paper just kind of texturally. So you can see how straight and tight that is across there. Then I'm going to make a little slit. I'm going to cut so that it goes straight down with both the top and the bottom on this flap, the last part that is going to get glued across there. And then I'm going to trim some of that excess from both the top and the bottom portions off. You don't want too much, but don't go all the way to the edge because then some of the board, that Davy board, is going to show through. If you made it tight enough, it's going to be hard to push that inside and underneath the cover. So you can use your bone folder to do that. So just push that in there, just fold it over that little bit that's left over. And then you're going to do a little line of glue again around the edge here and pull that up tight once more. So this is going to go, it's going to cause that tension from that outside area by the spine to the inside here and keep it very tight and very flat against the front surface again. And then once this is done, we'll put the end paper on there, but you kind of need it to dry in between. So get that wet, pull it across, pull it so that there's a lot of tension on there. Try not to have too much glue so that it won't ooze out. And you can already see that there are a few little discolored spots where the glue kind of oozed out on there. But again, most of this is going to be covered up with the end paper. I had a few stray threads that were coming from the cloth that I'm trimming off here. If that happens, you can trim those off, but you also probably want to put a little dab of the glue on there just to keep any more from raveling or unraveling out of it. Once I finish up each side of the cover and let that dry, as I always do from each step, I'm really letting things dry quite a while. This is really the final part here, is gluing the last side of the end paper down. The other one is free. It's just glued along that edge by the spine, but this part actually is going to get glued down to the cover. So I didn't lay this down. It's a little harder to do it that way like I did with everything else. So I'm just dabbing glue along the sides, again, wiping some of it off before I put it on there and having it be kind of dryish. So you're going to do it on these three sides. Don't glue it down toward the spine on here. Just leave that open. But you're going to do it on those three sides. At first, I kind of push it down with my hand. You notice I'm starting in the center and going out and just making sure it has the right contact all the way around. And then I use the bone folder to really push it into place because I don't want any wrinkles to show up. I can kind of pull those back out at first if I just do it with my fingers before I do it very with a lot more force with the bone folder. This time I'm actually putting a piece of wax paper in between there as it starts to dry because I don't want any, if it oozes out, I don't want it to stick to the other side of the end paper. It's not as important on the other sections, but with this one it can really kind of tear it. So and I'm going to stick it under pressure for quite a while once I'm done. So I do the same thing on this side, and this is really the last portion of it. Put another piece of wax paper on this side after I've got it taken care of, and I stick it under the weight of these art history books with some other ones and let it sit there for several hours and really dry. And then you come up with this nice little bound book.